So in the previous lecture, I was discussing about this log variable, and I told you that log variable suffers from, actually log variable doesn't support mutual exclusion. That is the biggest disadvantage of this variable. And what was the reason? The reason was that these two lines, the lines which are written in the entry code, are not atomic. I mean to say that this line 1 and line 2 are separate lines. This while loop and this log is equal to 1 are separate lines. So just remember what happened there. There what happened? At this point, preemption happened. Okay. At this point, preemption happened. That led to the trouble. I mean to say that due to this preemption, the mutual exclusion got violated. Okay. And suppose if there would have been no preemption, then there was no problem. But but the problem is that line number 1 is a separate line and line number 2 is a separate line. If these two lines are combined within a single line, okay, if these two lines are written as a single line, then there will be no preemption at all. Then, so if that happens, then mutual exclusion will be there. Okay, so now in this video lecture, I will discuss about test and set instruction. So whatever disadvantage was there in the log variable, so in this test and set instruction, all those disadvantages have been taken care of, and you see after I will explain you this code, you will definitely come to know what I am talking about. You see here the code is written as, you see, boolean ts means what? Test set. Then in the bracket is written boolean star target. Then boolean rv is equal to star target. Star target is equal to true, return rv. Then while loop is written while 1, while in the bracket it's written TS, test and set, ampersand log, critical section, log is equal to false, remainder section. Okay. So here you see the problem that was there in the entry section. So in the test and set, the entry code is written in such a way. Actually, test and set is a function. Okay, function means what? It is a piece of code. So here the code is written in such a way that these two lines of entry section of log variable has become atomic. It means what? These two lines has converted into a single line in test and set, so that we can achieve mutual exclusion here. You see here how it will work. So let's start from this point. Okay, so should I rub this? Okay, fine. So you see here, so it will start from here. Okay, so it's a simple C code, but don't worry, I will explain everything. So here you see, suppose there are two processes, process P1 and process P2. Okay, process P1 and process P2. So both these want to enter into the critical section. So suppose process P1 got the chance. Okay, so here process P1 will execute this line. Okay, so let me give number, line number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then it's 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So now process P1 will execute line number 1. Okay. So process P1 will execute line number 1. After that, process P1 will execute line number 2. Okay. And you see what's written in the line number 2. It's a while loop. Okay, it's a you see single statement while loop, because you see here it's semicolon is there. Okay, it's a single statement while loop, and you see what's written inside the bracket, TS ampersand lock. So here you see, a TS function is being called here. TS means what? Test and set. Test and set function is being called here, and you see the parameter is ampersand lock. So ampersand lock means what? Here you see there is a log variable, and also one thing you should notice that in this example, in this code, we are using Boolean variable. Means what? It holds the value either true or false, not 0 or 1, but true or false. So here log value is initialized as false. Okay, so just remember this point. Here the log value should be initialized as false. Okay, so now you see, and the address of this log variable is suppose 100. So now here you see test and set function has been called here. So where is test and set function? Here you see Boolean test and set. So from here to here the test and set function is defined. So you see test and set function is being called here. So just go to the test and set function, Boolean test set. So it means what? Boolean test set means what? Test and set will return a Boolean value. It means what? Either true or false. Return where? Return here. Okay, so if here false is returned, then this while loop will be broken. If true is returned, then while loop will be not broken and process will get trapped here. Okay, let's see how. So let's see what's written in the test and set definition. Boolean test and set, Boolean start target. Okay, now you see here target is a pointer to the Boolean variable. Okay, and here you see lock, the address of lock variable is sent. Okay, and target is pointing to the lock variable. Okay, like this. Target is a pointer, because you see here star is used, pointer to the Boolean. To the Boolean means what? Here the value is false. False means what? It is a Boolean value. So target is a pointer which is pointing to the Boolean value. Okay, and now you see here what is written, Boolean rv is equal to start target. So now there is another variable rv, there is another variable rv which is equal to star target. What is the value of star target? The value of target is 100, and what is the value of star target? It is a dereferencing operator. So the value at the address, what is the value at the address which is pointed by target? Address is 100, and what's the value inside it? False. So it means what? RV will contains false f. Okay, now you see star target is equal to true. Now star of target means what? Here target is pointing at this location. Star means what? Inside this location. So inside this location it is true. So here I will write true. So it means what? Lock has become true. Okay, now you see return RV. Return RV means what? This RV value will be returned. Okay, it means what? False value will be returned. That's why here it is written Boolean, because Boolean type value will be returned. So now false value is returned here. So here you see TS, this function has received the false value. So the overall thing became false here. Okay, false here. It means what? The while loop is broken and P1 got entry inside the critical section. So now P1 is at line number 3. Fine. And also you see one of the most important thing is that this test and set function is an atomic function. Okay, when this function is being processed, here interleaving can't happen. Okay, and now you see another thing is that when this function got processed, log value became true. Okay, log value became true. So log value became true, it means what? Critical section is not empty, and yes, you see critical section is not empty, process P1 is there. So here basically what happened, here initially log value was false, here initially log value was false. Okay, so process P1, before entering inside the critical section, process P1 made it as true, and after that process P1 got entry inside the critical section. Why process P1 made it as true? Because when process P2 will try to enter inside the critical section, due to this true value, process P2 will get stuck in the while loop. That's why. You see how. Now you see process P1 is already here. Now process P2 tries to enter. Suppose preemption happens, and now process P2 tries to enter into the critical section. Okay, now you see what will happen. Process P2 will execute this line number 1. Fine. Now process P2 will execute this line number 2, which is very important. Okay, and let's see whether process P2 could be able to come break this while loop or not. Okay, let's see. Now the new value of lock is true, which is set by process P1. Okay, process P1 has set the lock value as true, so process P2 will find it as true. Okay, now you see here test and set function will be called, ampersand lock. Okay, now you see here test and set function is there. So what's happening here, you see boolean start target. Now here target is pointing to true. Okay, target is pointing to the address of the log variable. Okay, and now you see boolean rv is equal to start target. Now you see rv is equal to start target. Rv is equal to start target means what? What is the value in, what is the value present at the address which is pointed by the target? So address pointed by the target is 100, and what is the value present inside it? True. Okay, now you see boolean rv is equal to start target. So now rv contains start target means what? Rv will contain true. Okay, now start target is equal to true. So start target is equal to true means what? Start target is true, and it is further, it is modified to true. Okay, it means what? Nothing change has happened. Now return rv. Now rv is returned. So it means what? This true will be returned. So here true will be returned. Okay, so true will be returned means what? This while loop is not broken. Okay, this semicolon will execute, and P2 will get trapped in this while loop. Okay, process P1 is inside the critical section, but process P2 can't enter inside the critical section. Process P2 got trapped in the while loop. So here you see how the things are getting happened. So here you see there is no chance for the violation of mutual exclusion. Here mutual exclusion is definitely guaranteed. Why? Because test and set instructions are atomic instructions. Fine. And you see how P2 will come out of this while loop. It is only possible when P1 will come out of this critical section. So just let me tell you how. Okay, so now P1 has finished its task inside the critical section. Now P1 wants to come out from the critical section. So now P1 will execute line number 4. Here I have written P1. P1 will execute line number 4. So here what's written? Lock is equal to false. So now lock value will become false here. So here I am writing false. Okay. And after that, P1 came out of the critical section. It means what? It's a remainder section. It means what? It's rest of the code. Actually, P1 came out from the critical section after executing this line number 4. Now you see how the execution of line number 4 will help process P2 to break this while loop. You see how process P2 is in while loop. Here you see, here there is a busy waiting. Okay, here process P2 is doing nothing, but it simply got trapped in the while loop. So here you see what will happen. So now, since the log value has become false, so now you see here you see TS ampersand log. So here test and set function is being called. Here you see the definition of test and set. Now you see now you see at line number 6, boolean start target, same thing, target is pointing to the log variable. Okay, now boolean rv is equal to start target. Boolean rv is equal to star target means what? Now rv will contain false value. Why? Because star of target means what? False. So rv will contain false. Now you see return rv. It means what? Now rv is returned. So now false is returned here. Okay? Now false is returned here. So it means what? While false. It means what? While loop is broken, now p2 got entry inside the critical section. Okay, see this while loop is broken. So just see how mutual exclusion is guaranteed. Fine, are you getting it? So I hope you have clearly understood it. And even if you have not understood it, just don't worry. You just watch this video one or two times again, and now some important theoretical parts are left. Okay, so I'm going to tell you. So let me rub this. You see, the first important part is that mutual exclusion is there in test and set. Okay, and you tell me whether progress is there. Obviously progress is there. How? You just see progress. What I told you about progress: when one process is not interested, it should not let it should not enter other process to sorry it should not stop other process to enter inside the critical section. I told you about the progress. So here nothing such things are happening. Okay. If P1 is interested inside the critical section, P1 can enter. Okay, so here progress is clearly happening. You see here, if two processes are there, okay, and suppose process P1 wants to enter inside the critical section, process P2 doesn't want to enter inside the critical section. Okay, and since the log value is false, okay, log value is false means it means what? Critical section is vacant. So process P1 can clearly enter inside the critical section. Here P2 will not stop it. It means what? Any time, at any point of time, there can be one process inside the critical section. Okay, so here progress is also guaranteed. Third point is that bounded waiting. So bounded waiting is there. Just think, bounded waiting is there. So let me analyze, let me explain you. Suppose you see both process P1 and process P2 wants to enter inside this critical section. Okay, wants to enter inside this critical section. Suppose process P1 got the chance and it entered inside the critical section. So here I am writing process P1. P1 is at line number 3, means what? P1 is inside the critical section. So you see what will happen. When P1 is inside the critical section, it means what? The log value that P1 has made is true. Okay, so p2 can't enter inside it because p2 will get trapped in the while loop. And suppose p1 comes out from the critical section, okay, p1 comes out from the critical section after making the log value is equal to false. So here, so p1 is here, ultimately p1 came out from the critical section. So in bounded waiting, each process should be given some limited time for waiting. It means what? Process should not wait infinitely. But here it's possible that if process p1 came out from the while loop and before process p2 could enter inside the critical section, again process p1 would enter inside the while loop. How? You see, when process p1 came out from the while loop, okay, then the log value became false. So the log value became false means what? Critical section is vacant now. Critical section is vacant. Critical section is vacant for both p1 and p2. Okay, so it is, if critical section is vacant for both p1 and p2, then it is possible that again p1 can enter inside the critical section and p2 will again wait. Okay, and this can keep on happening. Again p1 will enter inside the critical section, it will make the value of log true and it will come inside the critical section. Okay, and p2 will wait. Okay, let p1 come out of the critical section, after that I will enter. But when p1 will come out of the critical section, the log value is made false. So before p2 could enter, again p1 will enter inside the critical section. So here bounded waiting is not guaranteed. There is no limit on waiting for p2, you see, either p2 or p1. Okay, so there is no bound on the wait. So that's why bounded waiting is not there. Okay, and if bounded waiting is not there, it means what? Starvation is there. Starvation means what? A process is waiting infinitely. So here you see process p2 is waiting infinitely. Why? Because before process could enter, process p2 could enter inside the critical section, process p1 enters inside it, and this is going on continuously. So here there is starvation for process p2. Okay, and you see another important point is that platform independent or dependent? You just remember in the last lecture when I was teaching you about the requirements of process synchronization, I told you about architectural neutrality. Okay, so you see here this test and set, it requires the support of operating system. How? Because you see, in the log variable case, the problem happened, the log variable was not supporting mutual exclusion. Why? Because there was a problem in the entry section code. Entry section code was not atomic. Okay, there were two separate lines were there. So here in case of test and set, those two separate lines are merged as an atomic instruction. You see here you can say it's an atomic code. There is no preemption can't happen here. Since preemption can't happen here, so it is supporting mutual exclusion. Okay, this instruction, how this instruction has become atomic? With the support of the operating system. Okay, so that's why it is platform dependent. or you can say that it needs the support of the operating system. Okay, got it? Okay, fine. So it was all about test and set. Thank you.